everyone, and welcome back to 3D Natives Lab. I'm Elliot, and today we're taking a closer look at the brand new UltiMaker S8, the latest evolution in UltiMaker's S line of professional 3D printers. Well, actually, that last part isn't really true, with the S6 also being out since yesterday, so we'll also be taking a look at this one. Now, if you're thinking this machine looks familiar, you're not wrong. In fact, 2 years ago, we reviewed the UltiMaker S7. And if you haven't seen that video, I highly recommend watching it after this one, as it covers a lot of the foundational features that are still very relevant today. The S8 builds on the same core philosophy that defined the S line since the S3 in 2019. Reliability, consistency, and a seamless user experience. But while it might not look radically different from the outside, there are some meaningful changes under the hood. Let's dive in. From a design standpoint, the S8 is nearly identical to the S7. In fact, without the S8 badge, you'd be hard-pressed to tell the difference between the two. Same clean lines, same form factor, and again, the same 330 by 240 by 300 mm build volume. The only visual tweaks are a black accent bar in the center of the frame, replacing the white one on the S7, and a slightly updated design on the print bed warning signs. Subtle, but that's kind of the point. The print platform remains a magnetic spring steel sheet with PEI coating, which we really liked on the S7 for its reliability and ease of use. Now, the more significant hardware upgrade is the new extruders, which are borrowed from UltiMaker's Factor 4, their flagship industrial machine. These new extruders are more precise and more robust, improving overall performance and print quality. Even though they look similar at first glance. Do note that like all UltiMaker printers, the S8 uses 2.85mm filament, contrary to the 1.75mm industry standard. The fact that so many components are reused from previous models is actually a big plus. Think about it, these parts are tried and tested, widely supported, and have proven to be reliable over time, with S3 printers from 2019 still running strong today. As you might know, UltiMaker merged with MakerBot almost 3 years ago. And since this merger, UltiMaker is now spelled with a capital M. But you might notice that the S8 still has the old logo. That's because it reuses the same front panel as the S7. And actually, I was told that UltiMaker is making new front panels for the S8 with the updated logo for when the stock of the current ones run out. So maybe the first few ones are limited edition. Like the rest of the S line, the S8 uses interchangeable hot ends called print cores. So the S8 is compatible with the print cores used in older models. It now introduces the plus version of print cores. These are made to extrude filament faster and consistently at high speeds. So, if it's not a complete redesign, what makes the S8 special? The real innovation is in the software and motion control. The S8 introduces Cheetah, a new motion planning algorithm that dramatically boosts printing speeds while maintaining accuracy and surface quality. We've seen a shift recently in the 3D printing industry. While hardware has matured, the real breakthroughs are coming from firmware optimizations and smart algorithms. And UltiMaker is clearly following that trend here. From a user standpoint, the UI remains familiar, intuitive, and responsive, just like on the S7 and fully integrated with UltiMaker Cura and the Digital Factory. Talking about the Digital Factory, it has also evolved and now includes a web-based slicer to easily prepare prints from anywhere. So this feature is only available through the premium plan. As always, UltiMaker prioritizes security and upholds its promises, holding various certifications to ensure that no data, especially sensitive data, ever falls in the wrong hands, or even those of the manufacturers. This focus on data security is particularly important given that UltiMaker operates in sectors ranging from healthcare to defense. Over the last few weeks, we ran several print jobs using PLA, ABS, TPU95A, and PETSIA. The results are as good as prints done on any printer of UltiMaker's current S line, only much faster. UltiMaker also recently unveiled a new material, CF Slide, which is a nylon reinforced carbon fiber filament that was developed to be printed with the Factor 4. And this material will also be compatible with the S8, as UltiMaker is working on adapting the profiles to perfectly print it with the S8. In general, prints completed noticeably faster than on the S7, especially for larger parts. UltiMaker's motion upgrade is clearly doing its job here. For some prints like this, we're able to trim print time from over 2 hours on the S7 to just over half an hour on the S8. All in all, performance-wise, this is an S7, but faster and tighter. Proud to admit that we have an old S3 at the office, which very rarely undergoes any maintenance. And despite the lack of love it gets, it still runs smoothly whenever anyone uses it. At first glance, the S8 might feel like more of the same. And to some users, that might seem underwhelming, like UltiMaker is just playing it safe. But here's another way to look at it. Consistency is a feature. UltiMaker has been refining the same core platform for years, and that means support, compatibility, and reliability are second to none. Their printers share paths, profiles, and workflows, and that's a real strength, especially for professional environments where downtime isn't an option. If you're already familiar with the S7 or even the S5, the S8 will feel right at home. But faster, more efficient, and just a bit sharper. Think of it like the Porsche 911. Not flashy reinvention, but focused evolution. Unlike the iPhone, there's a new one every year with slight changes. Coming in at a price point of $8,999, the UltiMaker S8 is a professional 3D printer targeted at businesses and professionals wanting a reliable, stable, and secure solution. But the great news is that UltiMaker has set out to make most of this easier to reach by launching the S6 the week we're publishing this video. Available today for $4,999, the S6 is very similar to the S8 performance-wise, but comes in the S5 form factor. You can think of it as a boosted S5, just like the S8 is a boosted S7. The S6 comes with most of the features of the S8, except for the included air filtration system, and the S6 comes in two variants. One was a glass print bed, which is particularly convenient for food safe or medical applications, and one was a PEI coated spring steel sheet like the S8. After a few weeks of testing, we graded the UltiMaker S8 using our usual criteria, and it scored 9.4 out of 10. To discover even more about our experience with the UltiMaker S8, read our written review on 3dnative.com. Thanks for watching our review of the UltiMaker S8. Be sure to check out our previous video on the S7 for a deeper dive into the ecosystem, and let us know in the comments down below what you think about this incremental but meaningful upgrade. See you soon in the 3D Natives Lab, and by then, happy printing!